Everyone, so it is about 1:33 a.m. on Friday, March the 29th. I'm just gonna go to bed in a minute. Had a really long day, a nice day, but a long day. And I've got some things to show you, as you can see, but before I get to that, I'm just going to quickly tell you how my ENT appointment went. It was, wow, I mean, I've been to this ENT before when I was dealing with the hoarseness and stuff, and I remember that the first time I went to see him for the hoarseness, I was there waiting for over an hour, and I think I was there like a total of 2 hours, so I didn't know how long I'd be there this time, because I didn't know if they'd have to send me for tests or whatever. So I took the day off, because I didn't know, like, I thought I would get to work quite late and then have to work late, which would be crappy. So, I just took the day off, and as it turns out, I went, and he took me right on time at 10:15, and I was done in 5 minutes. He looked at my ears, everything looked fine, and then he looked at my nose, and everything looked fine. And then he, you know, used, like, the tongue depressor to look at my throat and tell me to say, "Aw," and all that stuff. And didn't find anything there. And you know, I was telling him, like, well, you know, my ears are really hurting, a lot, and they're really bothering me and stuff. And so, you know, I explained to him how, like, you know, a couple of years ago it started as, you know, pain on the outside of the ear, but in the last few months it's been on the inside and it's been progressively getting worse. Hi, baby. And so, yeah, I was like, okay, yeah, it's getting worse. So then he looked in my ears again, to double check. Didn't see anything, no fluid, no redness, nothing. What's up, Riley? And, so yeah, he didn't see anything there. And then he put the scope, down my nose into my throat again. And I guess the one good thing is that he said my vocal nodules are almost gone now. The vocal nodule is almost gone. He barely saw it this time, so that's good. I have noticed an improvement in my voice. Now that my post-nasal drip is kind of under control and I'm not constantly getting colds. So yeah, he did that, and then he said that he was and then he checked with the tongue depressor again, said that he was having a hard time seeing my tonsils because of how my jaw is constructed or whatever. So he used his fingers to feel my tonsil. And let me tell you, I have the worst gag reflex ever, and I just had, like, a reflex to just grab his hand and pull it away, because as soon as he got in there, I thought I was gonna, like, throw up, because the gagging was, like, so bad. But he was, at least, despite my trying to push his hand away, he did get to the tonsils and said that they were fine. So he found nothing, absolutely nothing, no explanation whatsoever. The only thing that he said, it could be some tension, in my jaw and neck that could be causing the pain in my ears, but there wasn't really anything to be done about that. So he wants to see me back in 3 months just to follow up and see if everything is same or worse or whatever. So yeah, that's what happened at the ENT. So it was pretty non-eventful. So I was glad that I was finished quick. So I came home. I got home about 10 after 11. Paula came over around 12 and stayed until about 3:45. So we had a really nice visit. I haven't seen her since before Christmas, and she brought one of her new reborn dolls, Freya kit by Tina Kiwi. She just recently got her. So, you know, I just took a picture of her new doll with Jamie, and we just caught up and talked and had a nice doll afternoon. And then I had a quick bite to eat, and then I headed over to Isabel's, and I got there about 5:30. And we chatted for a little bit, and then her friend came over, who, it was my first time meeting her friend from her work, and we had a nice dinner. We had lasagna, salad, some nice bread, and followed by apple crisp for dessert, and then we all went to Target. I just wanted to go with them because I wanted to hang out with them. I haven't seen Isabel in a while either. And none of them had been to Target yet, the new one. So, we all went. And I ended up buying some more stuff. I couldn't resist. But, I think after this I'm really gonna slow down because I really need to, save for the trip. Because I'm sure there's going to be some fun stuff at the doll show that I'll want to get. So first I want to show you that, obviously, as you can see, I ordered a dog tag, a Reborn-style dog tag from Reborn Princess 53. And I also ordered... Let me see here. I also ordered a Reborn-style t-shirt, which was quite wrinkled, and I didn't know if I could iron it, so I washed it, but then it kind of cracked a little bit in the wash, but it's okay. It's cute. It's a newborn size. So I got that in the mail the other day, and then at Target tonight, I caved, and I got this, girl's monkey blanket, because I don't have any girl monkey blankets. I've got plenty of boys, as you can see over here. I've got a boy one I got on Etsy, and then there's one in the bassinet for the boys, and then I also recently bought another boy one from Winners. So I just wanted like a really fleecy girly monkey blanket. So this one's like really, really cute, so I got that. And then I got, Isabel gave me a little gift for Easter. She gave me this cute little monkey. Isn't he cute? That was a nice surprise. And she had like a basket of plastic Easter eggs with little chocolates in them, and she let us each take one of those home. And I got more Paul Frank socks. Isabel stumbled upon these in the little girls section, even though it says on here, ladies socks, size 9 to 11. So these should have been where I got my other Paul Frank socks, the first time I went to Target, but they weren't. They were in the girls section, so Target messed up. So I like these because they're longer. I'm not a fan of the short ones. I mean, they're okay for the summer, but I think these would be nice for like the fall and winter as like socks to wear around the house. So it's got Paul Frank there, and there with like a flower. So I got those for myself, and then I got some earrings, and it's really interesting. I am allergic to nickel, and I noticed that all of their earrings there are nickel-free. And I've actually been noticing that more and more places are carrying mostly nickel-free earrings now. So, it kind of brings up a point that it seems like a lot of people are allergic to nickel. So I got these. I'm not a fan of the silver balls. I don't think I'll keep those. But I liked these. I thought they were cute. And then I also got these earrings right here. I thought they were really pretty. I love the purple. And then I got this dress here. I hope it'll look okay. I got it for Savannah. Because I've decided that the blue plaid dress will go to Avery. Paula even thought that it suited Avery better. So I'm going to exchange that one for a newborn size. And then I'm hoping that this will look nice on Savannah. Let's see. Yeah, I think it's hard to tell because it's dark. But I think that'll look cute on her. And it was only like, how much was it? $8. So I got that. And then I didn't see these the first time I went to Target. I just found them today. And this is so cute. You otter hug me. How cute is that? And it was only $5. And to go with it, I got these newborn size jeans that were $5 as well, because my boys don't have jeans, so that was cute. And then I also got, let me see here, I also, oopsie, it's falling off the hanger. Hold on. Oh my. Sorry. That was horrible. Horribly done. Yeah, it's like falling off the hanger. But, I don't know if you'll even be able to see it really well. Oh dear. Hold on. It's hard to do this one-handed. Where the heck is the hanger anyway? Oh gosh, it's like down here. Okay, there we go. It's like a little pole shirt, and it's got a monkey in a digger. And then it has these cute little gray shorts with like these little pockets. I just thought that was really cute. And it was only $8. It was really nice. So, yeah. And then they had this beautiful girls set that was like a yellow. It had like a yellow hoodie with like a little girl on a onesie and pants. But they only had a newborn size, and I wanted to get 3 months for one of my big girls because I have way too many newborn sizes, and I need, like, the bigger stuff for these girls. So I'm gonna keep checking back, and hopefully they'll get those in stock. So that's it, guys. I'm really tired. I'm gonna go to bed. I got quite a bit of rooting done last night. I've got a good pace going, so my hands are really sore right now. So I'm hoping that they'll be okay tomorrow so that I can root tomorrow, because I'll be home all day. Anyways, guys, see you in the next video. This went way longer than I intended. Bye, guys.